Hello and welcome. I'm Uli Newkirch from Corning's Advanced Research and Development team. Today, I'm showing you a demonstrator for high-density optical connectivity in a co-packaged data center switch. For this hypothetical switch, we picked a configuration that reflects what is currently being discussed in the industry as a likely choice for these next-generation units. A 51.2 terabit per second switch ASIC surrounded by 16 optical engines with a bandwidth of 3.2 terabits per second each. As a challenge, we chose the so-called DR4 signaling format here, running at 100 gigabits per second per fiber. That choice requires 64 data fibers to be attached to each optical engine for a total of 1,024 fibers inside the switch box. In addition, an external light source is connected to each optical engine via 8 fibers. These sources are implemented here as blind-mate pluggable modules at the front panel and at 128 in-box fibers, which could be either polarization-maintaining or standard single-mode fiber. All components are assembled in a rack housing that is only one unit tall. With these choices, the number of fibers inside the box and at the faceplate is exceptionally high, thus requiring connectivity solutions of highest density at the chip edge of the optical engine, at the faceplate, and for fiber cabling. Let me describe what we have set up here, starting at the optical engine. Assuming edge coupling, we chose fiber array units, or FAUs, which attach 64 data fibers to the chip edge at a pitch of 127 micrometers for a shoreline requirement of 9 millimeters. External laser sources are connected via a second 8-fiber FAU with standard 250 micrometer spacing. Now on to the cabling. We have realized two different variants in this unit. On the right side, data fibers from a single optical engine are grouped in four ribbons of 16 fibers each, which are routed to the faceplate. Note that in this configuration, ribbon groups belonging to different optical engines are routed without crossing each other. This simplifies assembly and improves serviceability, as individual optical engines with their permanently attached cabling could be replaced without touching the cabling of any other engine. On the left side of the unit, fibers are routed in small diameter tubing for extra protection, if required by the customer. Crossing-free routing is more challenging here and not demonstrated. For switches with fewer fibers, as would be the case for FR4 signaling, crossing-free routing can be realized also with these cables. The last part is faceplate connectivity. For the optical connectors at the faceplate, we chose an upcoming high-density solution that is being introduced by US Connect. The MMC connector houses 16 fibers in a compact format with an effective density of 28 fibers per square centimeter. This makes it possible to place 1,024 fiber connections as well as 16 QSFP-sized external light sources onto the one unit tall faceplate with room to spare for venting holes. You can see that we chose to connect the optical engines directly to the faceplate without midboard connectors. While this may make assembly more difficult, the advantages are significant. First, the optical insertion loss is minimized and on par with the current solution using pluggable transceivers. Yes, the fiber run is longer than in pluggables, but its insertion loss is negligible. That stays also true for potential routing in tight bends, as Corning provides bend-insensitive fiber in single-mode and polarization-maintaining versions for both the 1310 and the 1550 nanometer wavelength ranges. Second, a minimum number of connections also minimizes both return loss and multipath interference. Third, costs are minimized. And finally, real estate use is minimized too. In closing, let me emphasize that what you see here is just a pair of possible realizations, and it may not reflect exactly what the industry will choose in the future. Corning, with its comprehensive portfolio of connectivity solutions, has the expertise to support any configuration of co-packaged switches. Thank you for watching our demo. Feel free to contact us with questions. Goodbye.